So modal verbs are words such as can, could, should, shall, would. All such words are modal verbs. Why do we use such words? To talk about ability, capability of something, somebody, or to talk about the possibility or probability of few things. So these are the words. Now just have a look at all these words and identify the word or the modal verb that gives you trouble, or you are unable to decide which one to use, or at times a confusion is there in your mind. So these are the words: can, could, may, might, will, would, shall, should, ought to, must, have to, need to, had better, used to. So let's look at all these. Can and could, when do we use them? When you have to talk about the technical possibility of something. Technically, something is possible. Then you use can or could. Could is used for the past possibility. Can is used for present. For example, the color of this PPT can be changed. So that's technically possible. Something can be done. You go somewhere like, oh, yes, a car can be parked over here. It's possible. Technically, it's possible. It could be done. So we are talking about past. So when we refer to the past ability of something, capability of somebody, something, we use could in past and can for present. Where else can we use and when do we go wrong? Usually I hear students using can and able together. I could able to do this. I can able to help you. So that is wrong. Please avoid the uses of able with can or could. We should not use them together. So I can do this, not I can able to do this. One common error. Next is that could and can also be used for other things. How? If I have to make an offer to someone, can I help you? Right? Can I do something for you? So can has been used. Now, when we request people, can you help me? Please, can you do this for me? So this is casual way. Could you help me, please? Could you repeat the question, please? Could you just explain that to me? I didn't quite catch that. Could you explain it to me, please? Speaking test, when you do not understand the question, when you have to request the examiner, could. So could is always a polite way of requesting someone. Where else do we use could? Now let's look at another area and then I get back to this. I said can be used to make an offer to someone. Can I help you? When you go to the banks and hotels, etc., you find something written over there, may I help you? So may I help you? Nobody seeks your permission over there. That's an offer to you, that may I help you? That's a formal way of offering help to someone. So may can be used to offer, to make an offer. Can be used to make an offer. Then may can also be used to talk about possibility of something. So I said can is used for technical possibility. May can be used to talk about possibility of something, maybe in the future. Yes, it may rain today. It might rain today. He may join the class today. He might join the class today. What's the difference? May shows more possibility and might shows less possibility. And the way we use may, like the way we use might for possibility, similarly, we can use could also for possibility. Then in that case, could and might have the same meaning. I might be absent tomorrow. I might go there. Yes, I might go to this place in the future. That means some less possibility is there. I may go, more possibility. But the way I use might, I might visit this place in the future. Yes, I could go there. So could can also be used to talk about possibility. When the possibility is less, the way we use might. But in negative, we should not use could the way we use might. Like, I might not come tomorrow. I could not come tomorrow. Wrong. But you must have heard people saying, yes, I could help you. I might help you. Here the meaning is same. So might is used for possibility. Now let's look at another area. I'll get back to that. What you asked me, that one of you asked me, that you get confused between could and would when you talk about past, could have done it or would have done it. Let's look at another aspect of may. May is also used to seek permission. So may I come in, please? Or May I speak to so-and-so, please? Here you're seeking permission. And when you say, could I speak to so-and-so, please? You're requesting someone. So there's a lot of difference between the two. Now, will is also used to make an offer. Will you have something, right? I'll do it. I'll help you. You are offering help this way. Will, when we use it for future tense, that's a different case. This is a different one. As modal, you use it to offer help to someone. Now, how do we use would? Let's come to would and then understand the difference. I'm transferring the control to everybody in case you wish to ask me any question in between. So would can be used for past also. Past, if I have to talk about a repeated action in the past, something that happened quite often in the past. Earlier, I would see movies on Sundays. I used to see movies on Sundays. So I've used to also, and I've used would also, something that happened quite often, something that happened as a routine regularly. So I use would for that. Remember that girl, she would always be on time. So here we use would to talk about the past habit. So this way, would can be used for past. Then would is also used in conditionals. We have those conditionals. If you work hard, you will. Now, if you talk about past, so if you had told me earlier, I would have helped you. If you had gone there, you would have got whatever you wanted. You would have got that dress. Here, I'm looking at a conditional. It's a condition. That condition is fulfilled. So if you had gone to that shop, you would have got that dress. If you had gone there, had you gone there, let me meet someone. So in conditionals, we use would. Yes, I know, I could have got that. Now there's no condition over here. Yes, I know. That means there was a possibility. I could have got that. Technically, there was a possibility. Yes, I know, I could have got that dress over there. I should have gone there. So should have gone, that was the right thing for me to do. Let me just repeat these three sentences. One of you asked me the doubt that you get confused between I could have or would have. I think, so if I say that, Sneha, if you had gone to that shop, you would have got the dress that you wanted, right? If you had gone, there was a condition. If you had gone to that shop, you would have got, then that condition would have been fulfilled, right? There was a condition. So your response can be, yes, I know, I could have got my dress there. I know I could have. That means technically it was possible for you to get it there. So you won't say that, yes, I know I would have got it there. No, yes, I know I could have got it there. So I should have gone to that shop. That means what was the right thing for you to do? I should have gone. So in a conditional, you use would over there, if you had done this. Yeah. These are also the past forms for, like could is the past form for can, might is the past form for may, would is the past form for will. So in your speaking test, let's come to speaking, because after all, it's all about IELTS that we are discussing, and we have this class. It's all to do with IELTS writing and IELTS speaking, where we use all such words. And in listening, these words can make a lot of difference. In listening, you may hear, yes, I can. And then somebody might say, yes, you know, I might. So you listen to such words carefully. They'll help you to get the accurate answer. Okay. So in speaking, at times, you talk about past things. So then I thought that I will help or I will take up this job. No, I thought. So you are reporting your thoughts. So that word thought is in past tense. I thought that I would. So the word that should be used is would and not will. So when you report something of the past, please use the past form. Yes, he told me that. Then my friend told me that he could do that for me. He could help me, not he can help me. So this is a common error in speaking test whenever we have the speaking practice and you talk about past. So at times can, may, and will are used when you talk about past. Please be careful with that. Now let's come to shall. And should, when do we use shall as a modal? Shall for future time reference, for future tense, is different case that we discuss when we have the tenses. Other than the tense, Where else do we use shall? Yes, Sneha, to ask what?
Permission.
Okay, shall I say something now? Now, when I said, shall I say something now? This is not permission.
Oh.
I'm suggesting something, shall I? Right? Shall I start? Shall I say something? Right?
Okay.
Shall I do that? So, this way. So, you make a suggestion using shall. See, remember in English, we use these words to seek permission, to make an offer, to talk about capability, ability, to suggest certain things, to tell somebody what is right according to us and what is compulsory or what is necessary or what is necessary according to the situation. We use such words, all these words for that. So shall is used, one is this, when you make a suggestion. Shall is also used to make an offer to somebody. Shall I get you something? Shall I wait for you? Right? So this way also shall is used. Now, when do we use should? Should, of course, is the past form for shall. One is that. Should is used as a modal. You should do this. If I say you should do this, that means I'm telling you something that I consider to be correct. You should do this. You should go there. So I consider that to be correct. That's why I use should. Or he should be, because according to me, that's the correct thing. So that's why it's used when we have to advise someone, we use should. Now let's understand the difference between should, must, and have to, and ought to, of course. Ought to is used when we have to tell someone what is morally correct. Should is used when we tell someone what is correct according to us, what is correct according to the speaker. Here I would like to give you a very simple example. If you go out on a two-wheeler, your mother will tell you you should wear a helmet. If it's raining, then your mother may tell you you should carry an umbrella with you. You should be careful with your things. You should do this. So the word should is used. A police personnel will not tell you you should wear a helmet. In their instructions, they do not use the word should. What do they use? Must. You must wear a helmet because according to them, it's compulsory, it's mandatory. You must, if you read the prescriptions like medicines and all, it's written, must be kept away from children. That means according to that authority, according to those people who have manufactured that medicine, according to them, it's mandatory that it should be kept away from children. So that's why it's written, must be kept away from children. When you go to maybe any beach and all, at times it's written, must not venture out into this area, must not go. So who puts up that? Somebody use the authority over there. So according to those people, it's necessary. It's a necessity according to them. If I say that, like, you must use a dictionary as often as you can. So I feel it is mandatory if you have to appear for any competitive exam of this kind. You must. If I say you should, then I give you advice. Now, if we use have to, so in your speaking, please understand when you use all such words that what it might mean. Have to is used when something is required to be done according to the situation. You all are planning to take your IELTS exam in the near future. So you must read a lot. You've got no option. You have to read. You have to read, right? So you have to means according to the situation. For example, if you are on a two-wheeler and there is like vigilance is there, the police patrolling is there, they may catch you if you do not wear your helmet. So you've got no other choice. You have to wear a helmet. So according to the situation, when something becomes compulsory for us, necessary for us, we use have to. Need to, something is necessary. You need to go there. I need to do this. I need to complete my work. I know I need to do this. I need to pass this exam. It's necessary. So we use need to. Now let's look at had better. had better is a strong warning to someone. You had better go there. You had better complete this work. Like, you had better meet this person. Otherwise, you'll have to face the consequences. Somebody tells you, maybe your friend tells you, see, you had better improve your English. You had better take care of your... So you had better take, you had better improve. We use V1 form. One thing you all remember, please, after all these models, we use the present form of verb and without any ascending. So you had better improve, you had better read every day, you had better practice regularly, otherwise you'll have to face the consequences. So it's that kind of warning. Now let's look at used to. So one was to talk about the past habit, common mistake. Used to is used by many to talk about present. I used to read a lot of books. I used to play the piano. Now, what are you talking about? You're talking about past habit, not present. And used to can also be used to refer to past facts. Used to. I live, like the city that I live in, used to be a smaller place earlier. So in the past, it was a smaller place. So that way we can use used to. So it's, we can use them even to talk about past also. Let's look at these, this must. Must can also be used to talk about possibility, by the way. What one possibility of this kind, if any one of you has not had lunch today, you must be feeling hungry now. You must be feeling tired. So possibility, more chances are there. Right? You must be tired now. You must be feeling hungry. Then slightly less than that, let's look at the degree. So must, more degree, then you may be hungry. You might be hungry. So may less and might least. That's the way they are. Let's say suppose somebody annotates over here and makes us, let's say this has been, just assume that I have not done all this. So then I guess, okay, Sneha must have done it. Surety. Or if I say Sneha may have done it, some chances, right? Then Sneha might have done it. So possibility is less. So this way also we use them to talk about the possibility. Who could have done this? So who could have done this? Oh, she must have done it. She may have done it. That way we use. So we're going to practice today now. I hope few things are clear to everybody. We're going to practice. I'll be asking you all to speak also. Please participate in the activity so that I can help you with your weaker areas. We can identify those weaker areas. So let's move on. Few basic things are clear.
So ma'am, I have a doubt.
Yes, Prateet, go ahead.
So can we use, if I'm asking somebody, like, would you be able to get this for me tomorrow? Is it a correct or right?
Oh, yes, a very polite way of asking somebody.
Like, so we can use like, would.
Yes, will you be able to get it for me tomorrow? Would you be able to? You are requesting someone. So would is definitely more polite.
And the one last one you told us that we cannot use, I used to do this and I used to whatever, it can be any activity.
You use it for, so, much for past.
Much past. For past. So if I want to use something for my current requirement, so can I say I used to go? Instead of you?
No.
Okay. So we should find some other word for this, no?
I go for. You use simple tense. I go for long walks in the morning.
Okay.
I should not say I used to go for long walks.
Okay, got it. Okay.
Present, you can use it only in this context.
Okay.
Let me just share that with you. If you talk about something that you have got accustomed to, right? Mm-hmm. So then you say, I am used to. Now, I'm used to what? Right?
Okay.
Present generation is used to waking up late, right? They have got accustomed to that. So I'm used to, or I've got used to. Okay, let me put a very simple one over here. The city that I reside in, when I came here earlier, I found it a bit scary when people overtook me from the left side. Okay. Now I've got used to it. I'm used to that now. I'm used to driving on these roads now.
Okay.
Right?
Got
so
it.
In this, just notice what we have put between the subject and used to. We have put the verb. Okay. I've got all such verbs will come in between.
Okay.
Right, let's move on. And let's practice a few things.
Ma'am, so I have a doubt of ought to, ma'am.
Ought to is for moral responsibility.
For example, sentence.
For example, Ramya, like you are, if you work for a hospital, so you ought to take care of patients even when you're tired.
Okay.
Morally. That's okay. Your moral responsibility over there.
Okay. Yes.
So a bit of revision of what we've done. Can, could, they're used to talk about ability. One area is this, like I can speak three languages. I can speak two. I can do this. If you talk about present ability, past, you'll use could. Oh, I could. I could ride a bicycle when I was just 5 years old, 6 years old. I could do that. Should is used to give advice, like you should study more often. Ought to is used when you have to tell somebody what is morally correct, according to you. A must, of course, necessity, something that is mandatory, compulsory, according to the speaker. Like he must apply for the job by Friday. If somebody says this, according to that person, it is the necessity. Might, could, may, I just shared with you, can be used for possibility. Like she might go to the movies tonight. If I say she may go, that means more possibilities there. And this kind of possibility, she could go, she might, both have the same meaning. But in this kind of possibility, do not use could if you put not with that. The whole meaning changes. So don't use could if not is used with that for possibility. So let's move on to some activity. In IELTS speaking, you get different topics and you talk about possibilities, capabilities, and all such things. So whatever it may be, here these words have been put, of course, like you use could, might, may. You have to talk about the possibility of your future plans. So it's not only these models that you're going to use. You can use the others also, according to the requirement. Another area.
For live online IELTS classes by expert instructors, log on to unolearning.com.